In order to install Victron Connect and connect to your battery gauge on your iPhone, the first thing that you'll need to do is go into your App Store and search for Victron. You're going to want to use Victron Connect. Once you get to the app, install it. When the app is done installing, please open it. Make sure that you allow it to find and connect to devices on your network. And also make sure that you allow it to use Bluetooth. You can also skip all of these demos. If Bluetooth is on, you'll see your battery monitor. It will be called Smart BMV, and then it will show an item after it, which is the serial number. Click on it in order to connect. It will ask for a passcode. The default passcode is 000000, six zeros, and then hit pair. Once it connects to your battery monitor, if you wait a few seconds, it will prompt you to change your PIN code. We recommend pressing change PIN code and then typing in a new PIN code. So let's assume that somebody was born on January 1st, 1990. We would type 010190. We're going to repeat it again, 010190. You can show your PIN codes if you want to confirm. Otherwise, hit OK and your PIN code has changed. The next thing that we recommend people do is go to this little gear icon in the corner here, click there, and then where there's these little three dots in the corner, we're going to click there and then click on product info. We recommend changing the name of the device so that it is something more descriptive. If you're at a van event or somewhere else where there are multiple people with Victron products, you might not know which one is yours if you do not change the name. So we're going to edit this, and we're going to come here, and we're going to change it to something like demo video. Now this device is named Demo Video. The other thing you want to note down here, if you ever want to change your PIN code in the future, you can change it using this right there. If you ever turn off Bluetooth, it is very difficult, if not impossible, to turn back on. So don't turn Bluetooth off. If we go click back here and we exit out, you'll notice that it's called Demo Video because we renamed the device. Once you click back into the menu here, you'll see a number of things. You have state of charge, which is 0 to 99%. Voltage shows current. It shows power, consumed amp hours, time remaining. We generally recommend ignoring time remaining. It can be very misleading because it is just a short average of the current power that you're using, and then relay state open. Don't worry about relay state or time remaining. Up here at the top where it says history, this will show the entire history of the device. So this particular battery monitor, since it's been used for a long time, we've seen 433 total kilowatt hours of charged energy and almost 400 total kilowatt hours of used energy. Under trends here, you can change, we might ask you to change these if you're having an issue and send us a screen capture of something like voltage and current, or voltage and power in watts. In general, you don't need to worry about the history or the trend screen unless we have a tech support question. If you click on the gear icon here, if we ever want to see what your settings are, this is where you would come and find your settings. So your battery settings are here. You have relay settings, alarm settings, display settings, miscellaneous, and then VE Smart networking. On your display settings, you can turn off certain things on the actual gauge itself. So you could, let's say you don't want consumed amp hours, you could toggle that off. You don't want watts to show, you could turn off power. If you just wanted to show voltage, amps, and state of charge, now it's just showing voltage, amps, and state of charge. We ship them with all of these on if you have a 21 plus system, and then in earlier systems we also turn on starter battery voltage. If you're at the main device screen here with the latest Victron firmware and the latest updates to the app, you can see your voltage, you can see your current, and you can see your state of charge. If you click the down arrow there, it will expand it to show everything. So you don't even need to go into the device on the newest firmware and software revisions in order to see everything. You can just click, and then it will show you everything you need to see. If there is ever a software update, when you click on settings, it will warn you and say that it needs a firmware update or a software update. If that's the case, you can update it. Do not interrupt the update process. It's best to have your phone in Do Not Disturb and airplane mode with the Wi-Fi and the Bluetooth on so that a phone call, text message, nothing like that disturbs the update process. If you interrupt the update process, you might have to reset the monitor in order to fix it. If you're ever having trouble connecting to your device, you forgot your password, you think something's wrong, the best thing that you can do is remove it from the Bluetooth menu. To do that, you're going to go to Settings on your phone, then click on Bluetooth, and then find the device on your Bluetooth list. The device here is called Demo Video because we renamed it. If it was still called BMV, it would still be called that. So you can click on Information, and then you can forget the device. Once you've forgotten the device, if you go back to the Victron menu, it will, once it resets, it should ask for the PIN code again. Perfect. So now that we've cleared it, we can enter the PIN code again. It was 010190, and hit pair, and it will connect. So that's how you can delete the device and then re-add the device. If you try to connect to your device and you do not get the passcode correct, or just to enter the passcode period, it's going to ask you to enter the code shown on demo video. That is very misleading. There is no code that will show on your device. What this means is enter your PIN code. So the PIN code of this device is 010190. If I enter in the wrong PIN code and then try to pair, it will keep warning me that the PIN code is incorrect. And I can keep trying. And until I have the PIN code correct, it's going to keep telling me, enter the passcode shown on the device. If you've forgotten your passcode, there is a way to reset using what's called a PUC code. We have that code for many systems in our database, and if we don't have it for your system, it's on the back of your battery monitor. If you ever have to reset your passcode, you're going to click on these three little dots there and then reset PIN code. It's going to ask for the PUK, the PUC code, off of your device. Once you enter that PUC code and hit enter, you can reset the password to whatever you'd like. The PUC code may be available from RoamRig. On later systems, we have that recorded. Otherwise, we can instruct you on how to get it off of your physical battery monitor display itself.